His Excellency General Yakubu Gowon, welcome to Ibadan for IITA's 50th anniversary.
Thank you.
How are you doing today?
Fine, thank you very much. Delighted to be with you for the 50th anniversary, golden jubilee of IITA.
And you were president when IITA started.
Well, certainly. I think the discussion, as you probably heard, discussion between the Ford Foundation and Rockefeller Foundation started right back in 63. So that is during the First Republic, and it continued until the 67, when it was my honor and privilege to really sign the decree.
Can you give us a little bit of background story, how it never happened or how it almost never happened?
Well, yes, I think the main problem was, I think, might be the problem because the First Republic was doing their best to do it. And then, of course, came the change of government. And, soon after that, again, there was another change of government. So all the work that had been done by the initial ministries, etc., I think was probably put on a hold. And then, of course, came the change of government, and now not the politicians that were involved, it is the permanent secretary, the public servants, permanent secretaries in charge of agriculture or economics or whatever it is, that were now involved. Now that was how I came in, and of course nothing was done up to that time. And then when it came to my time, yes, we had to look at it very seriously, consider the importance of this particular institution or program that is being suggested. And despite the crisis that we had at that time, the work has to continue. Although we have crisis in one part of the country, the rest of the country, there is need for us to also look after their interests while we deal with that particular interest in order to restore them to the family, and so that we can also take care of that area as well. So that is the main problem. Then, of course, there came the question of looking for land and paying for compensation for economic crops, and also for the people that are going that their land is being acquired for the purpose of this particular program. Just like it was done for the University of Ibadan, University of Ibadan. And so it happened that it was me who had the honor and privilege and God's opportunity to endorse that scheme, and to sign a decree the institution IITA is to come into being in Nigeria. And from that time right to the time that it was officially commissioned, I think this process of trying to get the land and all the compensation that needed to be done in order to acquire the place, and also for us, for some of the buildings, etc., to be started, and for it to be commissioned, not only as a signpost, but as really a living institution. Well, I think someone was telling me that it was originally thought Abeokuta was the one to be the one, but I've never heard of that until today.
Oh, okay.
But however, I think Ibadan came for one reason or the other. It was not possible to do it in Abeokuta, and so of course it was moved to Ibadan. And of course, by that time, if you remember, the university is well established, and of course there is the Ministry of Agriculture. So I think the proximity of the university, the Ministry, and the Department of Agriculture, this would be a very good thing to do, because they can exchange ideas and thought on developing the program here. Yes.
Well, we have you to thank for the 50th, definitely.
Well, let me say thank God, and thank you for thanking me.
Thank you.
Certainly would thank the Rockefeller Foundation, Ford and Rockefeller Foundation, for really bringing this to the government of Nigeria, and of course the process that it took for it to come into being. Yes, so I think all need to be, I think thanks, all around. As I said in my opening remarks, certainly what I was on the side that General Wandie Adebayo is not with us. He just missed it by a few months. But certainly he did quite a lot to ensure and to convince the local population the need to have this institution here, and to agree on various compensation that needed to be done in order to acquire the land. And of course, the federal government had to pay for it, because it is a national and international institution which the federal government is responsible for. Yes.
So did you ever imagine that in the last 50 years, did you measure up to your expectation? Do you ever imagine that it would be what it is today?
Well, what it is today, certainly it has advanced beyond anyone's expectation, any of our expectation. At least, we know that it is going to progress year by year. And we knew its value during our time. The advice and the support that I think various departments of agriculture throughout the country, throughout the region to start with, then the state, the value of some of the advice that we are receiving from IITA, which is usually put in our various program, either development program or annual budgetary consideration, for improvement of agriculture in the country. So yes, it has really done exceptionally well, and honestly, as I've said, it went beyond what we were expecting at that time. And as we can hear, we can see the progress that is being made, even the thought of the future. It is really most encouraging, and I'm delighted now. I think we're trying to get some of the very successful businesses and foundations in the country to be able to at least make some contribution, at least to take over from the foreign donors for the work of the IITA and the improvement of agriculture, not only in Nigeria but throughout Africa. All that I would say, advice that I will give them is that please, work hard, do well, and really improve the productivity of African or tropical crops that we all live on. And the interesting thing I see is that the population, what I've had today, the population of Africa yeah. is going to be how many times over? My goodness me.
Yeah.
And so where are we going to get the food? But it seems as though the improvement in cassava and yam, and so I was thinking, what is the cause of this population explosion in Nigeria? Is it the cassava or the yam that we eat? Because it seems as though that is where some of the greatest productivity, but that is what seemed to give rise to having so many many children. Yes, but honestly, when you look at it, look at TV Land, for example.
Yeah.
Why they produce a lot of yam, and the population. My goodness me. Am I going to sort of say in the West too?
Well, in the West, to be honest. In the West.
Well, how about
Oliver?
Oliver.